Yeah.
We're on live already.
Well, we're live.
To tell the people what's going on.
I mean, what's up, baby? What's going on?
Introduce yourself. What are you plugging?
Hey, how you doing? My name is Matt Mitrione. I'm a professional fighter. I fight in Bellator. I used to fight in the UFC, and I get to punch a big old Tebow Goo in his face on February 16th. His name's Roy Nelson. He's actually the second best heavyweight in Bellator right now. I'm the first, obviously. And I'm going to dot him up. I'm going to punch him in his face, and we're going to be on TV on the Paramount Network, which is formerly Spike.
Nice.
How you like that?
I like that.
I appreciate it. I'm a Purdue guy.
So here's the thing. I have my show. I do a daily show.
Yeah.
But every Thursday, my producer steps out from behind the camera. He's in Toronto right now.
Okay.
And he and...
Is he Canadian?
He's Canadian.
Okay.
Both Canadian guys on the show.
Okay. You're Canadian now.
I'm Canadian too.
Okay. From where?
I am from Halifax, Nova Scotia. Okay. But I live in Toronto.
Is that Mad North or is that East Coast?
That's way east of Maine.
Okay, yeah. All right.
So not too north. It's just
you guys, that's a lobster. A
lot of lobster.
A lot of lobster.
Good lobster, yeah. Too. Although
I have a good friend of mine. One of my only adult friends where I live is from Montreal.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it George St. Pierre?
It is not. It is not. As a matter of fact, I went the first time I ever went to Canada was with Jesse Palmer, and I didn't know that Ottawa was the capital.
Were you on The Bachelor, too?
I was not. But Jesse and I are still in touch. Good dude.
That's awesome.
Solid guy.
You didn't have to go to Ottawa, did you?
Because I did.
Ottawa's awful.
I did for Jesse Palmer's golf outing, and I was like, we're going to. I was on the phone. I was like, we're going to a place called Ottawa, and he's like,
it's capital.
A place called Ottawa. Place. Yeah, go figure.
Get to meet all the politicians. Canada's really very little people.
Yeah.
We're not huge. So the big thing is, so my producer once a week steps out from behind the camera. I go behind the camera and switch everything up because I don't know the most about MMA.
Right.
These guys.
As a Canadian, that's almost a religion.
We're good at it. Yeah. The Canadians love stuff we're good at.
Yeah.
So hockey, MMA.
You guys had Rory McDonald.
Rory McDonald.
Just won the title.
Did he win the title?
Did you see that?
I didn't know. This is why, I step behind the camera.
Use your phone. Look up Rory McDonald's leg, hematoma or just leg.
Oh, God. It's not like the...
No, it's not.
It's not like this...
Anderson Silva? No.
Yeah.
But, dude, it's aggressive.
Can I find it on Twitter?
I'm sure you probably can. Watching it live, or Bellator 192, I'm sure it'll come up also. You'll figure it out.
Man. Rory McIlroy or Rory McDonald?
Rory McDonald.
I don't think Rory McIlroy is taking that kind of heat.
I don't think he is either.
And
Rory
it was
McDonald. He's like the Red King or something like that.
Rory
like
McDonald.
Rory McGorilla or something. I don't know where he's at.
So if I just searched Rory McDonald.
Oh, no. Did you? Yeah, you did it.
I'll just put in. I'll put in Rory McDonald videos.
It's not Rory McDonald, is it? I forgot his name now. Rory something. It's not Rory McDonald. It's Michael McDonald, but Rory. What the hell? Whatever. Anyways.
This is why.
His leg. It was like he got this hematoma from being kicked, and his leg just like ballooned. It looked like he had a shin pad. It looked like his leg was pregnant. Just ballooned right out. It was incredible.
Okay, so
and he still won the fight. Won the title with it.
He still won.
Roy's a beast.
I got him to send me some questions because he was fired up. You were going to be on.
Let's get it done, brother.
All right, so you need from Paul Shaughnessy, host of the Dogger Pass podcast. He wants me to ask you about the Travis Brown eye poke and your recovery.
Travis Brown eye poke. Okay, so I was fighting Travis Brown. Dropped him in the first. And then I had this one thing that was specific for Travis. He's long, right? He's like 6'7", something like that.
It's a big man.
Yeah, and I fight lefty, which usually is awkward for right-handed people, especially if they're athletic.
Is that an advantage for you?
It is. I'm naturally right-handed, but I fight lefty because the movement throws people off. And it opens a couple of different angles that most righty-on-righties don't have. So I utilize that. I capitalize on that. So I was fighting here. I threw a straight left, stepped over the right hook. And I throw a straight left again, and the straight left again is to get you to reel back where your head's past your heels. And then I throw a big old hook to come in and finish it up, right? And that's my sleeper. And I hit the straight and the hook, and I stepped over, and I hit my straight again. And when I was coming in to throw this hook, he was going back, and he realized his head was past his heel, so he couldn't be defensive or evasive anymore. And he goes like this and pokes me in my eye.
So was it intentional?
It happened again like about a minute later with the exact same setup, and that was his response again. So is it intentional? No, but that was his chosen defense to that strike.
So he had no defense.
So he had no defense. Then that was like putting his hands out like this, and now they have a rule against that. If you put your hands up in a defensive posture and you poke somebody in the eyes, especially if it happens twice.
Game over, you win, or is it just straight up no contest?
It was like either points taken away or like the fights, I don't know, something. But then I was like, I told the ref, I was like, I can't see, I'm seeing double, I can't see.
How? I mean, people always just yell at the refs in MMA, like, oh, you stopped it short, you let it go too long.
Oh, it's a thankless job.
How do you know?
Dude. Well, you know, in a situation where you say, like, you know, look, I can't see, I'm seeing double, I'm impaired from an infraction, then the fight's supposed to be over. The ref was like tweeting Travis Brown 3 days before the fight, hey, I hope you're doing okay, like stuff like that. And I was like, why would you be tweeting a guy I'm fighting and you're refereeing the fight?
That's
like,
odd.
What the hell's going on here, you know? And so anyway, so that fight, that it took, so I couldn't stop seeing double. I got poked in the eyes, right? And then I slipped the punch that's from the guy on the right, and the guy on the left just dots me straight in the face. And it hit me, and I was like, damn. I was like, I think he broke my orbital bone. And then like a couple seconds later, he grabs me, dumps me on my shoulder, which is how I got that lovely thing.
Can I touch it?
Yeah, go ahead. My kids use it as a handle.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Does it hurt now? Obviously not.
No, not at all. It doesn't hurt at all.
Can you use that as a move?
I do. So, like, if I'm in up against the wall, and I'll be bumping him in like this. I do it. For sure, I'll poke him in the eyes. And then after that, he won that fight. But that's why, like, I'm 12-5, but I don't really consider two losses. His is one of them. So I consider myself really 14-3.
Well, do you get, like, extra points and extra wins for knocking out Fedor?
I should, right?
Yeah.
Especially the way that happened. Did you see that fight?
Oh, I didn't.
Dude, it was madness. Like, it was almost like a Rocky Balboa, Apollo Creed, like, when they hit each other and, like, they, you know, at the same time. We hit each other at the same time, dropped each other, and, like, when I hit him, I must have landed a little bit heavier because his head bounced off the ground and he still looked up. Well, I just got dropped and hit my butt. And I jumped up and I was like, I better finish this dude now. I don't want to stand up much more with him.
So he was basically doing the Undertaker act.
Yeah, for sure. Like, that's what it was. And he saw me coming up, so he just kind of dove under for a single. And I started hitting him, and then he fell back, and then, yep, and slept him.
All right, so I got some more from Paul here.
Let's get it, baby.
Ask him who he thinks he'll face in the heavyweight Grand Prix final. Yeah,
finals.
And you gotta beat Roy first, right?
I gotta beat Roy.
You're gonna win.
I will beat Roy.
You're here talking.
I will.
So you're gonna win for sure.
That good mojo. Let me think. Who do I think will win on that side? I think Fedor beats Frank Mir, and I think Fedor and Chael will actually be interesting. I think Chael can really give Fedor a lot of problems.
Were you stunned Chael beat Rampage?
No, I predicted it.
You did?
Yeah.
He was the underdog in that fight.
Yeah, but not really, because like Chael.
For the odds, he was the underdog.
I agree. Chael likes to wrestle, right? Rampage hates fighting wrestlers. Chael is a dog. He's a bulldog. He's going to get on your hips. He's going to stay on there all day. He's going to do everything he can just to be here, right? Rampage wants to throw hands. If he's on your hips, you can't throw hands anymore. You have to be cognizant of where your hips are sprawling, and you can't use your hands anymore. So because of that, I'm just using it as like a dummy. I'm hitting you up.
Listen,
here.
Listen, that's all I am anyway. Just, here, right? I'm easy to chuck around.
apparently that's how it goes. You just have a face everybody just wants to push on.
You know? You say push on. Listen, I've been punched in the face over 40 times in my life.
40?
I've run my mouth, and I look like this. People don't like when it's a little guy running his mouth. I have a very punchable face, yes, people tell me.
From the jail cell, right?
Well, you talk about breaking your orbital bone. I broke my orbital bone.
Did you really?
I had a sucker punch like this, cut me right here with a ring, still got the scar, turned around to see what was going on, and just bam.
Got it again.
Orbital's gone, nose gone.
Let me get your finger here. So, look, I got this one here. I got a plate and four screws right there.
Oh, wow.
You feel that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, like, my kids always like touching them. They're always like, what's going on here, Dad? Like, they're always like, are you going to set off the alarms in the airport? No, I'll be okay. But anyway, I don't remember where we're going with that story.
All right, cool.
What's up? Am I running over?
I guess so.
I'm running over.
I got one more.
I told you I'm a talker, man.
You are. We got to touch. That was. You got to push me around.
It was
a
really
bit.
Romantic.
You got to tell people how punchable my face is in person.
Was this kind of like our first date?
A little bit.
We got the first.
Don't tell your wife.
You know, I'm divorced. It's okay.
No, so we're good.
Yeah, we're good here.
Listen, I think in Minnesota I can adopt the kids too. We're
for
good.
For sure. We're solid.
Let's see. No, that's gonna be it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's gonna be it. It just everything on here.
Good.
It's kind of crazy.
I appreciate it.
You knocked out Kimbo Slice?
I did. Good dude. Solid fella. We drank beers afterwards.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So is that sort of a thing? It's like a hockey fighter? Like you get into a fight and then afterwards everything's all right?
Yeah, there's
no like real bad blood?
No, not really. Sometimes, yeah, but most of the time it's just theatrics. Well, so put some butts in the seats.
Well, good luck. Knock out Roy Nelson.
Thanks, brother. Appreciate it.
Thanks for stopping by,
dude. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Enjoy your time on Radio Row.
Yeah, you know it, brother.